can't let your mom see this footage. Oh, I hope your mom never watches this footage of us doing super dangerous things.
This is so steep and dangerous. Remind me not to ever show your mom this footage.
Remind me to erase this footage. You have asthma, right? And does that make it a little scary to hike high passes and in the high country in the Sierras?
Yeah.
High elevations are harder for you, right? Because your lungs have more trouble.
Yeah.
We're going to do Kearsarge Pass today, and that'll be your first pass that's almost 12,000 feet. This will be a really great test to see how your lungs handle that elevation. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if we can't get up there, then that's fine. We will have a beautiful trip as high as we can go.
We have the oxygen level thing, so...
We can monitor and make sure that you're totally safe. We're ready to go?
Why are we doing it in the sun?
I don't know. We... Okay, anyway. Well, yeah, it was going to be this way, but then the sun is going to be in the lens. Okay, Kearsarge Pat. Ray Likes, here we come.
Wait.
Never mind. Tomorrow. Well, so we needed the chasing knife?
Yeah, we need a chasing knife. Because murderers will bring chasing axes. And if we only have Swiss Army knives, then that's not going to do anything. You should get a ultralight chasing axe.
I don't think they make ultralight axes, but we could look for
it. It was a pretty good hike. Do you want to go back?
What?
Kind of hungry. You ready for lunch?
I was fit. All right, let's go. And yeah, it does start uphill. Weird how mountains are that way. That is a Pikachu. Stop. It's a beautiful morning. It's perfect hiking weather. Stop. Don't mar up. Don't deface this. Smart water. The smart choice. That looks so ridiculous. She has hiccups. She's so stupid. Hiccups while you're backpacking. Oh my gosh. How'd you get up there? Got a little boulder field here. Always signals the approach to Flower Lake. You can swim in any lake you want. This is a good spot to see the fish jump. So Audrey just kicked her trekking pole off the giant boulder. And it's right down there. I wish I caught that on film. She sat down, set her trekking pole down, started to roll. She moved to get it and kicked it off. Here, baby. Yeah. What's your blood oxygen?
Oh, now it's 90. It was 89. Now it's 90.
Okay. That's good. Why are you laughing? Hey, listen. Shh. No, it's so quiet. No, I'm not gonna do a slow pan. I'll do a whip pan. Whip pan, ready? Whip. There's Owens Valley. I think you did it. I think your hiccups are gone. Can I help you get up? I know the feeling. This high elevation, man, it's like your muscles feel like they're not working. You're doing great, honey. Floopy? You feel floopy? Oxygen level now is what mine was about 45 minutes ago. So tell them you're busy on a mountain.
Yeah, that's your business.
What have you been asking me if you can see for this whole hike? I just realized we're going to see the pass and that I didn't want to ruin it by telling you. Come back. See those jagged rocks? Just to the right. There's a dip. That's the pass. Hair is thin. The pass is behind me. Close. What lake is that? Big pothole lake. You're higher than you've ever been in your life right now. How does she keep getting so close to the pass when all she does is sit? I'll tell you how. Magic. How close? How close? We're so close. Look how steep this is. She did it, ladies and gentlemen. Seven sixty. Conquered Kearsarge Pass. Congratulations, honey. You made it. You made it. Okay, let's go. That's a view. I love this descent. It feels so good going down. Oh, don't fall off. And we're moving. This is a great descent. It always feels good. We're gonna have a super easy afternoon. All we have to do is get to Kearsarge Lakes, scout for a beautiful campsite, find the best one, set up camp, take naps, eat, relax, watch the fish jump, read, nap some more, eat some more. It's gonna be amazing. What a great day, huh, Bogle? Are you falling down? Do you feel the oxygen yet? No, no. That's it, no. That's different. Ooh, look how steep it gets right here. This isn't going to be fun coming up. So this is the high route. And you take the high route if you're going to Ray Lakes or getting back to the PCT if you're a PCT through hiker or even a JMTer who's resupplying here. You ready? Mm-hmm. That is so clear. Getting close. Ooh, this has got the spot for two. This could be it. What you got going on?
I got my alpaca socks.
You got your thermals. You look pretty warm. You're gonna be nice and toasty for sap all over your thermals. Preparing dinner. Boiled the water already with the esbit, and it's gonna set here inside this hot sack for 10 or 20 minutes. Dehydrated rice, beans, and taco seasoning. Then we'll add some Fritos on top, some black olives, some Cholula hot sauce, some sharp cheddar, and some avocado on the tortillas. So after our naps, we had some dinner. There's Audrey's setup, and here's mine. So we can talk at night. So we're walking down to film the fish because they're jumping like crazy. This is surreal. That background is surreal. What was that?
My pillow is perfect.
Oh, nice. So you were warm last night.
Yeah.
And it was 32 degrees was the low.
Are those wolves?
I don't know, actually. I ready for a warm-up hike? Okay, let's do it. That's the pass behind us.
Ma chambre à la forme d'une cage. Le soleil passe son bras par la fenêtre. Les chasseurs à ma porte comme les petits soldats qui veulent me prendre.
So I'll take the dangerous route. Oh, I hope your mom never watches this footage of us doing super dangerous things. Remind me to erase this footage. Oh my gosh, secret tent sites. And a shovel. That's weird. A shovel. Huh, what a view.
I like this one.
Is it good? Good. Nice.
That was a good one.
Good job, honey.
Yeah. Oh, look at the tiny little trail to the water.
Somebody wants this campsite bad. Pretty much one of the coolest campsites I've ever seen in my life. That's true. Somebody's excited. This is the lake draining into the lower lake. That is so cool.
Such a cute little lake. see what's on that side. I wish it could
take one. Let's go. Let's look. And yeah, that's Frog Lake in the distance. Pretty? So we got to the end of the world here.
We know love by this, that he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. If someone says, I love God, and hates his brother, he is a liar.
Tell the people what we're doing. We packed up.
We packed up and we're going to a new campsite. It's better.
Good. Okay, we'll edit that out of the video. Everything you said. If you fall in, I want to catch it on film. What do you think? Is this the campsite? Campsite number two for night number two. Pretty beautiful. So, basic tarp setup. Finding the path of least resistance down to get there. We're gonna go cross country to Bullfrog Lake, adventuring in the High Sierras.
This is so steep and dangerous. Remind me not to ever show your mom this footage. Everywhere we turn, there's cliffs and rock slides.
She'll never let you go backpacking again. We're going down there. Looks like sure death. I'm ready. Can you walk?
Yeah.
Did you rock lake? Okay, smile. Round three. One, two, three. Not a good smile. Don't get shot. So Audrey and I just stumbled upon this. It's completely full. So my first thought was, functioning okay today? I'm not. Our first thought was, it's for a resupply for JMT or PCTers. And they just have friends, good friends, or hire people to pack it in over the Kearsarge Pass and put it here. Then they don't have to go out over Kearsarge Pass to resupply. Because this is a long, it's a long stretch from Horseshoe Meadow and resupplying out that way, or straight from Kennedy Meadows all the way up past Horseshoe Meadow, past Cottonwood Pass, over Forester Pass, all the way up to the Kearsarge Lakes area, Bullfrog Lake and all that. So resupply makes sense right here, but whose stuff is that? It's like filled. So that's a mystery we'll have to look into. Very interesting. I mean, it's so remote, it's off the trail. Maybe some kind of private thing for pack mules, for hired, or for rangers to go into the ranger stations? The ranger resupplies for the... Anyway, just thought I'd talk way too long about the bear fox. And once again, it's not a trail. That's where water goes in the wet season. Not trail. This is not good footage. So Audrey didn't want to go straight towards Bullfrog Lake. She wanted to walk by water. She's very difficult to backpack. Very difficult. You're so lost. You're lost. Whoa. Wait. That's a cool tree. Dang. Wait, you've never seen a grouse? Oh, you're gonna love them. They're so cute. They're like little fat birds that walk around. They have like spotted feathers. You're gonna love it when you see a grouse. It'll be your favorite bird. So they're kind of brown and not really pretty. Yeah, we just discovered this. We're the first ones. I'm not gonna say pretty. Yeah, the sears are okay. Hiccups?
Yeah.
Really? Again? Why do you do that? What are you playing there, Audrey?
Into the woods.
Why are you doing that?
Because we're in the woods.
Are we really? I don't think we're in the woods right now.
Well, we're gonna go into the woods.
Fishies.
Yes.
I'm guessing because there are lots of bullfrogs at the lake. I'm not gonna film this really gross skeleton at all. So basically your question is, how does a deer die in the mountains where they live? Why don't they live forever? How's it feel? Refreshing?
Yeah.
So that's Bullfrog Lake from the west side. So Audrey and I are hiking the Kearsarge Pass Trail towards the PCT just to see the junction and then go back. That's just a little something something between Bullfrog Lake and the PCT. Another little surprise of beauty. If you're a PCTer and you had to resupply up this trail. Yeah. Let's see the sign. Oh, that's not a good sign. Here it is. We did it. High five. Yep. The trails go north and south. We're just saying goodbye to the PCT. We made it. We'll see you another time. Let's get back to camp. So we went off trail for the last section and we're heading, we're dead reckoning with being right under, yeah, that one. We made it back to camp. Yeah. Is it good?
Yeah.
And what is that?
Chowder. just
looks, looks like good corn chowder. Well, it's been a long time,
long time. You want me to do that?
No. So tomorrow's plan that we are in 100% agreement on is we got an alarm set for 4:30 a.m. I know that sounds crazy, but that's why we're having dinner early. We're gonna go to bed early. Gonna get a good night's sleep at 4:30 a.m. We're gonna pack up in the dark and we're gonna make our way up Kearsarge Pass. We're gonna get to the pass to watch the sunrise. How's that corn chowder? See some of that. See some. Show the camera. People want to see. Good. Good. Ooh. That. Audrey and I just watched the first half of the life of See Your Life of Pets Part 2. I know this won't be on a YouTube video because people will say, that's blasphemy of nature. Why would you do that? But we laid up on this flat rock with the sun going down, and it was so beautiful, and we were just enjoying that. Now Audrey's getting snuggled up in bed. I'm about to get under my tarp, and I'm gonna try to sleep as fast as possible because we're getting up at 4:30. So tomorrow will be, I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. Good night. Good night, Buggle.
Good night, Bubble.
Sweet dreams. There's the pass. Straight up.
Already hiked 0.6 miles. So now we only have 0.5 miles left.
The times we have. You gonna do the whole pass walking backwards?
Yeah, I bet nobody's done that before.
No, I pretty much guarantee no one's done it before. You can't let your mom see this footage. A few more switchbacks. Congratulations. Two times over. Pass. It's almost 4,000. Awesome job. Awesome job. Breakfast. Ready, set, go. So while we were making breakfast, or actually just before we started making breakfast, a young lady came hiking up. Her partner came up, and they we're gonna do the Ray Lakes Loop in a day. So they're trail runners. That makes it about a little more than 50 miles. A lot of elevation gain. Just to get down all the way to 4,000 feet elevation, could be a little higher. And then they have to climb over Kearsarge again, which is almost 12,000 feet. So that's a lot of elevation gain on the way back up. Nice couple. Whoa. So steep. Yep. No, I understand. They almost look unreal, what you're saying. My favorite switchbacks. How you doing, Audrey? How's the hike down? Ooh, that breeze feels great, doesn't it?